Well, good evening to everybody. I hope you all can hear me well out there. My name is Johnny DuPree, and for some of y'all who don't know who I am, I'm currently serving as the mayor of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. And I've been the mayor of Hattiesburg for three terms, well, two and a half terms. I'm in my 10th year. Prior to that, I served on the board of supervisors. I was elected three terms, and then prior to that, I was on the school board. I'm mayor. My wife is here with me. I've been married for 38 years. She stuck with me through thick and thin, and I do appreciate that. We have two daughters. One teacher at the University of South Alabama, and one teacher in Jackson, Mississippi, both school teachers. Education is high on our list. It is very high on our list, and it should be high on everybody's list. Why? Because if you're not educated, you don't have the kind of license you'd like to have. An educated person is able to find a job already. They're healthy. They stay married longer. All the things that you want out of life come from being educated. But I want to tell you a little bit about me in Hattiesburg, Mississippi, because that's really what I'm running on. All the other governors, candidates, all those who are running for candidates and governors, they will tell you what they want to do. I will tell you what we've done. The other thing that you can go do, and you can actually look at my record, you can find out where we solved all the problems in Hattiesburg, and I'll tell you that no, we have not. That we attempted to do it together, that we attempted to solve all our problems together. That's what we do as a government of this state. When you look at Hattiesburg, you look at where we've come, you start talking about jobs, and I know that's what's interesting to everybody's jobs. The last year, one of the very first things we did in Hattiesburg was when we had a climate where we actually had 1,000 jobs that were created in Hattiesburg last year. We actually created another 1,000 jobs by inviting a company to come to Hattiesburg called Stadio. Stadio is a $500 million company with 40,000 jobs average. It's coming to Hattiesburg to do solar panels, an emerging company. So we're doing real well as it relates to jobs in Hattiesburg. I'll tell you something else that we've done in Hattiesburg as well. You know, this last census, I know all of y'all talk about your children being educated and they staying home. Well, you know, I want my children to stay home too. At least I want them to be able to come back home to Mississippi, because Mississippi's a great place to be. The last census says that the greatest demographic growth in Hattiesburg is 24 to 29 year old young people who came to Hattiesburg and stayed in Hattiesburg. They make up 27%, they recruit about 27%, and they make up 11% of our population. So, you know, that's what we need to be doing for the state of Mississippi, is creating an environment so that our young people can not only be educated here and grow here, if they want to leave, they can leave and have something to come back to, and that's what we want to do. Also in Hattiesburg, we want to look at where we are on our economic level. We have more people that are coming to Hattiesburg. We grow about 100,000 people from 8 to 5. That's because our healthcare is good, our education is good, our roads are good. All things that people want in Hattiesburg are good, which means that if you look at Hattiesburg, they're going to talk about the top 10. We're in the top 10 of almost every category of the community. Now, what does it have to do with the state? Well, that means that I'm the only one that actually has had the experience of running government. I mean, actually running government. You know, I know what it means when taxes are raised on the state level, it's raised on the federal level. I know what it means when services are cut on the state level, or cut on the national level, unfunded mandates. I understand that. I understand that because when it's done on the state or federal level, the people that have to contend with that are in the counties and in the cities. And that's what I've had to do over these last 20 years. I've had to contend with all those things. And so I'm offering myself up for service because of the experience that I've had. I'm offering up myself for service because we have the experience of working with people, black, white, rich, poor, Democrat, Republican, because we want to make Mississippi first, and that's really what this is all about. It's about taking care of our children, it's about educating our children, it's about making a place for them so they want to stay here. And so I'm asking you that on August the 2nd, if you would vote for Johnny DuPree, I want you to go vote first of all. I want you to pray about the person that you vote for, because the person that you vote for really has to be the person that's going to carry us into the next 20, 30 years. Start that ball down in here. Pray about the decision. I believe you pray about the decision, and your vote is earning the truth. God bless all of you, and thank you all for being here.